Today I'm going to show you how to create an expense tracker in Excel that you can keep on your phone. When I was a kid, my mother used to purchase everything by check, and she would keep a check register with her checkbook, and she'd always enter the checks into the checkbook tracker so that she would know exactly what her balance was at all time. I've designed this worksheet to be just like the checkbook tracker that she used to carry around with her. You can carry this on your phone, and as you spend, you can keep tally of what you have spent. So in this sheet here, I have the date, I have what we've done, I've said the payee, the payment, deposits, and there's the balance. Always at the top, I have the current balance, and that's so that you want a quick look and see if you have enough money to buy something, you can just quickly look and there it is right at the top. So let me show you how I did this. So I'm going to start on another sheet. The first thing that I'm going to do is in A1, I am going to type in the word balance. And let's pick a figure for B1. I'm going to start with $1,000 just because it's a round number. Now, that's not going to be our balance for very long. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to click into the next cell and I'm going to come back and I'm going to make it very small. So let's drop down the font size to be 8 because it's not really important. Okay, so then what we're going to do is we're going to leave this for our real balance. And now we're going to put in a line of headings here. We're going to put in date. We're going to put in type, whether it's a purchase or AT or cash withdrawal or whatever. And then we're going to put in payee, who you paid this to. And then you're going to put in the payment, so what you've paid. And then if you've deposited any money, you're going to put it in here. And then you're going to create a balance. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to darken these headers just because so I can see the rows that are different. So I'll just make it gray. And there we go. So in the first line, I'm going to put the balance that we're starting with. And so I'm going to, in this balance, I'm going to go equals, and I'm just going to reference the cell where we put the $1,000 in here and press enter. Okay. So then in the first row, we can enter in the date of what the transaction that we've done. So let's say it was 3rd of December. Right, and then we'll just make that a little bit bigger. And let's say it was ATM, which is like, and so we're taking out cash, and what we've took out, we've taken out let's say $50. Let's say on December 4th, you received a check and we'll put check in here and deposit. And the deposit's going to be, let's say, $300. So now let's work out the balance here. And so what we're going to do is we're going to do a formula, and we're always going to we're going to go equaling, and we're taking the balance from above us, and we're going plus whatever is in this column, and then minus whatever is in this column. And so now if you double click this, double click the fill handle, it will fill all the way down, and we can actually fill it again so it goes right to the bottom. Okay, so now how we're going to get the total so that it always appears on the top. So you want the total to be always the balance, whatever's on the bottom. So what we're going to do is we're going to go equals, and we are going to go the initial value here, and we're going to go minus, and then we're going to go opening bracket, and we're going to go sum, and then we're going to go another opening bracket, and we are going to go starting at the second line here. And then we're going to get to the bottom of our sheet because we want everything that we've spent here. So we're going to press the Control, Shift, and down arrow. And it's going to go down to our last cell. And then we are going to close our bracket here and close our other bracket here. Okay, so we're minusing that. And then we're going to plus. And we're going to plus whatever we've deposited. So now I'm going to go back to the top of my sheet. And I am going to go, and we're opening bracket, and we're going to go sum, and then another opening bracket, and we're going to go the same thing as we're going to go in this first column here, or this first cell here. We're going to press the Control, Shift, down arrow, and once again, so we get to the bottom of the sheet, and then we go, and that will give us our total. So there you have that. The total here is what's there. Now, to make it so that you can easily see what your balance is at any time and what you've put in. So to keep our headings at the top, I've gone to the View tab. I've selected the first cell under the word date, and I am going to go to Freeze Panes, and I'm going to go to the very top where it says Freeze Panes. So now, you are able to scroll down and always have your headings on the top. And so here we go. Let's enter in another date and another. So 18. First of all, we're going to December 6th, 2019, and we're going to go ATM, and we're going to go cash. And let's say we took out another $75. And so there you go. There's your balance always at the top here. And you have an ongoing track of what you've spent your money on. So this is how you make an expense tracker for your phone in Excel. Please subscribe.